Good evening, everyone. My name's Shyla. And behind stage here, we have Amy, who's Emily's sister, and then her other friends, Joanna, Angela, Lisa, and Jesse, and Paul is on sound. We were on a church puppet team called No Strings Attached with Emily, and Emily was on the team with us for almost 10 years. And we absolutely love Emily, and we love Jeremy, and we made this for you two in honor of your wedding day today, so we hope you enjoy it. All right, so come along with me as I tell you the story of our heroine, Emily. A tall, beautiful woman, a little taller. Perfect. Emily loves horses and has lovely blonde locks. But this story is not just about Emily. It's about how she met her now husband, Jeremy. Jeremy, it's not your time yet. I'm sorry. What? Oh, Jeremy, I know you're excited, but you just have to wait a minute. The story has to be told in order, and it's not your time to come up yet. So you're going to have to go back down. I'm sorry, Jeremy. I will call you up soon, okay? I know you're excited. Yeah, bye-bye. Yeah. Okay, perfect. All right, let's get back to our story. When Emily was young, and even now, she enjoys riding horses. And Emily did really well in school. And as she got older, she joined her church puppet team, No Strings Attached. Along with them, she traveled to competitions and conferences, performing and sharing about what it means to love Jesus. She even went to Nicaragua on a missions trip. All right, cue Jeremy. Hi, Jeremy. Jeremy also did puppets as a young man, and he loved to travel, plan city infrastructures, and learn about many, many things. He even raised chickens. Aww. Raising chickens helped him learn where his food came from. He also raised honeybees. And he even made homemade beeswax candles and homemade lip balm. Jeremy, however, was looking for love. Eventually, Emily and Jeremy both decided that they wanted to share their lives with someone and set out to look for love online. Little did they know they would find each other. And after texting and video chatting for some time, Jeremy and Emily eventually decided to meet in person. Goodbye, chickens. Goodbye, bees. Jeremy just knew he had to meet and get to know this woman with the beautiful smile and bright eyes. Everything has changed. finally the big day of meeting in person was here, and the nerves were real. They were happy to learn that neither was an axe murderer as they hiked the remote Hockley Valley together on their first date. And after their hike, they sat on Hank. I guess I should specify and say that Hank is Jeremy's pickup truck. Jeremy brought out several drink options: coffee, hot water and tea, bubbly water, but Emily said regular water is fine. They talked about their love of nature, and they explored whether they were in the same ballpark for what they were looking for in a relationship, or at least playing the same sport. What sealed the deal? They talked about grammar. What? Grammar? Really? Okay. They talked about grammar, specifically the direct address comma, and they discovered that they had the same feelings about the use of the Oxford comma. And after a few years of dating, they entered the engagement era. Jeremy set to work designing a gorgeous ring for Emily with the stone color of her dreams. And after 2.5 years, he knew it was time for him to propose. Welcome to the wedding of Emily and Jeremy. Jeremy, you may now kiss your bride. Future hold. Emily and Jeremy have many exciting hopes and plans for the future. Lots of camping and finally sharing a tent. Canoeing and hiking, simply being together, talking, laughing, and creating inside jokes, sharing many adventures and meeting the unknown hand in hand, never having to do life alone again, being together forever. Whatever they do, they'll be happy anywhere. That concludes our performance. We just want to let Emily and Jeremy know that we love Tama. Yeah. I don't know, there's something. I'll say something. We love you and we wish you the very best in your future together.